Hello everyone and welcome to my channel again. In this video I will discuss different laser geometries and the properties that we need to measure to prove scientifically its usage and that or other properties that we can use in any scientific publication. So previously we discussed that a CW laser has a constant power with respect to time. And after insertion of a saturated absorber and due to fluctuation in this power, it gives rise to ultra short pulses whose pulse duration are constant and their separation is well defined. So what are the different forms of ultra short laser pulses? So the first one that I want to discuss is a solid state laser. In a solid state laser, you focus the CW pump beam to pump the gain material, and the gain material lays. And due to saturable absorber, and if the properties of the saturable absorber are right, then this laser will give ultra short laser pulses. Another geometry is fiber geometry. In fiber geometry, you need fiber gain material. You have isolator. To force the laser to work only in one direction, not in both. Otherwise, the laser pulses will collapse, and your laser cavity will not work properly. Then you need to have a saturable absorber, an optical coupler, and WDM. WDM is a device that allows you to couple a CW pump beam into the laser cavity very easily. Then another is solid waveguide laser. In waveguide laser, the cavity length you make to be very short, and it normally consists of flat mirrors, and you pump the laser beam into the laser gain barrier. It's mainly more or less looks like a solid state laser, but it is known as a waveguide laser because you may make a waveguide inside your laser gain material. Moreover, in this kind of laser, the cavity length is very very short, and the two types of lasers that are become very very common nowadays are Mixel and Vixel. In Vixel, you make the cavity length extremely short. You pump the laser beam, and you have a gain material inside the chip, and the chip lays, and the saturable absorber also is within the chip. In the Vexel structure, the only difference is the saturable absorber is not within the chip, but is outside the chip and in this geometry. But both can give you very high pulse rate, because the pulse rate depend upon the length of your cavity. If your length of your cavity is very very short, the pulses will come out very very fast. If the cavity is long, the pulses will come out after certain interval. So for example, long cavity normally has repetition rate of the pulses of the order of megahertz, whereas high or short laser cavities can give you gigahertz repetition rate. So what are the properties of the laser that are important to measure? So this is a paper that I want to discuss with you. So the first thing that you need to show is the spectrum of your laser. So now when the laser is working in pulse mode, then the spectrum will be extremely broad. So here there are four cases when different saturable absorber were used. So you can see the spectrum is quite broad. It is in the order of 2.9, 3.2, 3.4 nanometer, whereas if you have just CW laser, then the spectrum will be very narrow. So you can see the spectrum in this case is extremely narrow in comparison to all other cases. Another property that is very important to measure is the pulse duration of your laser pulses. So if it is ultra short pulses, then the pulse duration will be in the picosecond range, as you can see over here. They all are in picosecond range. Another property is to check the pulse separation, and this you can do with any photo detector. And in this case, you can see that the pulse separation was 64 nanometer. And since a laser cavity is an oscillator, so therefore you have standing modes, and these standing modes give rise to frequency harmonics. So the final property that is very important is to show the stability and harmonics. So this is a harmonic graph. So it not only contains the fundamental frequency of at which your laser is working, but it's harmonic, and it needs to be you can measure it up to certain intervals. So in this case they were measured up to 1000 megahertz. So this is what I want to discuss with you. In the next video I will talk about the use of ultra short pulses and laser for different applications. Thank you very much for watching this video.